Welcome to another guide too with me, Mr. SealyP. The new Holland TS Series. This is a mod out by ARM team. On the Modhub this says update, so this is an update for PC, but this is new out on console. And at the moment I've got a bit of a thing for these, you know, the boxier older kind of tractors. After having done the golden days of farming, let's play using mainly all old tractors. I've been quite looking forward to these coming out. And there are quite a few options available, as you can see. New Holland TS series were in production from around 1999 up to 2003, I believe, somewhere around there. As part of the, I want to get it right. What's a CNH group? But anyway, it's the big conglomerate that owns Case, New Holland, Steyr, Iveco. There's quite a few. New Holland Agriculture, New Holland Construction. A whole range of companies under their umbrella. So let's have a look in store, see what's available, and then we'll have a look down the models, as I usually do. So in store we go to tractors and scroll right through, and we get to the end and it just shows one. 85,000, and that's for a standard 80 horsepower tractor, 24 miles an hour. Now, for an 80 horsepower tractor, 85,000, compared to these, the cheaper versions of tractors here, it's quite a lot. What's that one? Oh, mind you, 80,000 for 105 horsepower, so yeah, it's about right, isn't it? So, anyway. Options available: weekend change, front loader attacher, no or yes. Engine setup, you can have the TS90 at 80 horsepower. You can have the TS100 at 90 horsepower. The TS110 at 100 horsepower. And the TS115 turbo at 125 horsepower. Those are your engine options. Then back to the TS90. It does say in between each of those it's the same engine size, but you've got a different option. You've got the TS90 and the TS90 Fiat Agri. The TS90 standard is the blue New Holland colour. The Fiat Agri version excuse me, is the slightly kind of reddy, rusty brown kind of colour, the Fiat Agri version. So you get two options in each engine size anyway, so you can have the blue or the sort of rusty red colour. Wheel setup, and this is where it also gets very interesting and very complicated. You've got standard low profile, wide low profile, narrow, and back to standard again. So we've got low profile versions in each of them as well. Then you've got fenders, none, only front, only back, all. So we can have a whole selection of different sorts of fender options. And then we go to clean windows or tint windows. So quite a few options available in there, and obviously the price will vary. If I go for front loader on, if I go for the TS115 turbo, if I go for wheel setup, what's the most expensive? Wide low profiles, yeah, wide low profiles, fenders, let's go with all fenders and tinted windows. It takes a grand total up to 93,100, which isn't horrendous. That will give you a 125 horsepower tractor with a few different options on there. So, coming back out, these are the options. So I've gone along the kind of row, starting with the smallest engine size up. So straight away, we're off with the TS90, the 80 horsepower option. The first one is with your standard tyres. And then you've got standard low profiles, and if you kind of look back, it's hard to tell at the angle, but these ones sit higher and come across than these ones. They're lower down. So these are the low profile options of the standard tyres. They don't look much different other than that. They just sit a little bit lower, which I think overall drops your tractor down a little bit lower to the ground. It's the sport version. It's been, done up. These are all the options you can have on this episode of Pimp My Tractor. Anyway, we're not going to be doing that. So, we will have a look inside this first one, because everything else on it will be the same. Nice details. Doesn't get too blurry. The lettering. It's nice. So let's just jump right on in, shall we? Start it up. Nice engine sound. We've got beacons. We've got lights. We've got rear work lights. And then we've got main beam. We have our indicators. All very fantastic. Now, if we look inside, mirrors are there. Interior is very tidy and incredibly detailed. Looking down to this side here, that's really, really nice. Really, really good. Speakers up on the top here as well. Not bad at all. I like this. It really has got a lot of detail. Now, looking at the dashboard, because I always tend to forget the lights. We turn the lights on. Dashboard lights up. We then go rear work lights. Another light comes on. Front work lights. Another light comes on. Indicators. And then everything off again. I like that. I like it a lot. It's a nice looking tractor. Now I'm sure there'll be the usual critics that will give it a dislike, because all people seem to be interested in all the time is massive tractors with huge horsepower and that kind of thing, and there is a place for that. And there are quite a few tractors that have that already, with the big buds and various different options. And I do agree, we have lately been getting quite a lot of small tractors, classic tractor packs, massive Ferguson packs, all those kind of things. So people understandably are looking out for something a bit different. One thing I forgot to point out with this one, no mudguards. This one doesn't have any ear. We've got this one is kind of built into the bodywork, but there's no actual mudguard sticking out from it. So this version has none. So this is the one with the low profiles, and this is the Fiat Agri version. As you can see there, Fiat Agri. Everything else is the same in cab. This has got the standard tyres, but these are low profiles. And this one I've gone with front fenders only. That one hasn't got any. That's got front fenders. Everything else about it is exactly the same, apart from the colour, obviously, which I've kind of already mentioned. Something I did find out looking online, looking at forums and things like that. On the actual TS series, people have a lot of problems with these, apparently. Leaking seals and all sorts of stuff. And apparently, the back wheels, the rims, have a tendency to crack quite a lot. You can upgrade to different ones, better ones, apparently, but they do crack quite a lot. So if you do decide to buy one of these, keep an eye out for that. Cracking rims on the back of your tractor. So, moving onwards, we now have a version, the TS100, which is a 90 horsepower. This is obviously the New Holland version with wide tyres. This one's got wide, low profile tyres. Also a TS100, but this is the Fiat Agri version. This one I've gone for rear fenders only. So as you can see, rather than just having that bit there, you've now got these fenders that stick out to the width of the tyres, and a bit around the back here, which this one doesn't have. So that's with the rear fenders. This one Here, the TS 100 Fiat Agri, I've gone with front and rear, so we've got fenders all around. But again, as you can see, you've got a height difference. If you look here, it's probably easiest to tell here, from the top of the tyre to the mudguard, that gap there. This one with the lower profile, you've got a much bigger gap between there and there. So these tyres are lower profile. It should actually sound here, does it? 565 R33s. No. Oh yeah, 650s. 500, is that 500 600? Sorry, 600s. 665 R33s. And these are 650s. So yeah, these are low profiles and these are the high profiles, standards, whatever you want to call them. Okay, so moving on in our range of options available, we've now got the TS 110. This is the 100 horsepower, and I've gone with narrows on this. Now, I've also gone with no fenders, no mudguards, whatever you want to call them on this, because I thought with the narrow tyres, if you had mudguards sticking out, it might look a little bit odd. I just thought with the narrows, it kind of follows up, it's not too bad. But again, it comes down to your choice, your options, whatever you think you would rather. But as far as the actual tractors go themselves, they're all identical. These are just options with tyres, fenders, that kind of stuff. This one is same. I don't think narrows, they don't do a low profile, it's just narrows. So that's on narrows as well. This is the TS110 Fiat Agri, and this one I've gone with tints. Now, unlike the tinted windows you got on, what was it, the Merlot mod, which were very black, these are more mirrored. They've got a real mirror look. They look really good, actually. That's a good quality tint on that. Very nice indeed. They do look more mirrored than tinted, but very nice indeed. And then lastly, in our lineup, we've got the big boy, the New Holland TS 115 turbo, or 115 turbo. It doesn't say turbo on it, but it is the turbo version, because rather than like with that one, with the 110 you're getting 100 horsepower, you think, well, the 115 you're going to be getting 110, you get 125 horsepower because it's got a turbo. And with both of these, I think, yes, I went with full fenders, wheel arches. They've got front and rear wheel arches, and these I went with wides just on both. I also went with tints on both, I think. Yes, I did. The tints on both. It's a very nice mod. Very tidy. Now, that's weird, because the further away, like now, that looks black. But then closer up and in certain lights, it looks mirrored. That's a nice touch, actually. I'm not quite sure, I mean, unless you're kind of some sort of superstar farmer, some celebrity farmer, and you don't want people seeing what you're doing. I would imagine the tinted windows, do they work better in sunnier climates, so you don't get the glare inside the cab and that kind of stuff? I'm not too sure, but these are your options available. Quite a few to choose from. Couple of colour choices to go with if you want to go standard New Holland and go with the blue. If you want to go with something a little bit different and go with the Fiat Agri version, you've got those options available. Various different tyres, various different fender mudguard options, tints, but just watch out for those cracking rims. And I don't mean cracking as in that's cracking, that is. I mean the rims cracking. I know it won't actually do it in the mod, but you know. And that's it. That's about all there is from those. I'm sure people will complain again. What's the point of doing a guide to? It's just a tractor, it's the same as any other tractor. But it's nice to show all the options that are available. You might go along that and think, you know what, actually I like that one, or I like the look of that one, so when I do mine, that's the option I'm going to go with. That way you haven't got to go through all of them to find the one you want. Spending money and testing things out, I'm saving you the time. I'm providing a public service. But anyway, if you have enjoyed this, found it useful in any way, shape or form, give us a like. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do. If you want to leave a comment, feel free. And if you want to share this video, then please be my guest. ARM team have done a brilliant job on these. Whatever you should choose to do, thanks for watching.